Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In 2021, I made a Microsoft OneDrive video, and the video is called OneDrive Sync Icons Explained for Files and Folders. I went into very detailed explanation about what happens, but I've since gotten some questions about this video. And this is a very popular topic, in case you're wondering, before I dive into this, how popular is it? I made it last year, but for this year, today is Easter Sunday. So from January 1 through April 16th of 2022, that video is number one for me in watch time. It is number two for views, number one for subscribers gained, and it actually ranks as number two for my revenue that I made for that video. So it's very popular, so let's go ahead and knock out these questions that I've been asked. The questions that I'm going to go through, I thought about this. I'm also going to make a Microsoft Forms quiz for them. So feel free to share the quiz with your coworkers or friends if you want to. That link will also be available down below, including the link explaining these three icons for OneDrive, which I've discussed in my video. But I'm going to be referencing them during the quiz. Real quick, the first one is cloud only. The second one is locally available file. And the third one is called always keep on this device. You're going to see this when I start right clicking on files and folders. Just to keep this easy though, I thought we would call these for this video. I thought we would call these cloud, green check, and white check. So, and they go straight down, cloud, green check, white check. Anyway, let's go ahead and get started with this video right now. So question number one I have for you is this. If I open up OneDrive and create a folder and add a file to that folder, what icon will it have between those three icons? And the answer is it's going to have the green check icon. Let's go ahead and prove that. I've got OneDrive running. New folder. I'm going to call this underscore test with Chris. What a great name. That should be at the top. There it is. Open up the folder. I've got three files I'm going to use. I'm going to pull just one right now. I'm going to just drag and drop a Word document. It is a very small Word document. There it is. The file has that green check mark, which means, again, locally available file. So question number two, what icon will the folder have? Because this is where people got confused between the files and the folders. Well, if I pop back here, the answer is that folder is going to have the exact same icon. There it is right there. If I change the file back inside the folder, if I change the file to cloud only, what icon will the folder have? The answer is it's going to be the blue cloud, cloud only. So first of all, let me change the file, right click. Real quick tip for you, and again, I've explained this in the other video, from the word share down to free up space, notice that they've got lines above the word share and below free up space. That is all OneDrive commands right there. I'm going to go and hit free up space. This file is no longer available locally. So if I didn't have an internet connection, I could not access that file without an internet connection. But the question was, what icon will the folder have? The answer is it's going to have the cloud only icon. Let's go back and test that. Test with Chris, and there you go right there. So far, it's been pretty easy, I hope. Question number four, and here's where it gets complicated. If I have a folder with a lot of files, what icon is the folder going to have? Well, let me show you this one. I'm going to open up Test with Chris because right now we got just one. Let me put the other two so we'll have three at the most. Drag and drop. By default, this was the first question. Those two files that I just pulled in here now have the green check. What icon is that folder going to have? The answer is the blue cloud. This is the one that drives people crazy. Let's test it. Test with Chris, blue cloud. So here's how this works, and it's really simple. If I open up this folder, Test with Chris, if just one file has cloud only, the blue cloud, the folder icon is the blue cloud. That is just how Microsoft decided to do it. Just to prove it again, watch this. There's one icon we haven't used. That's a right click. Always keep on this device. It's going to go from the green check. I did it for all three of them. So since I did it for all three of them, I'm going to just keep going. I don't want to edit this video right here. So since I did it for all three files, the folder will now have the white check with the green background. Just to prove that, watch. There you go. Back in here. Let's see if I can get this right now. Let me go ahead and put one back in the cloud, free up space. Let me do another free up space. Oh, this is great. There you go. And so now when you open or download a file, that is when you get the green check. So I'm double clicking. It's going to open real quick. I'm going to close it. It's my logo. There you go. So here's the question again. Sorry about that. Great exercise though. So now I'm using all three icons that we've been talking about. The folder is going to have the blue icon just to prove it. Look. Test with Chris. Right there. Let's go ahead and open that up again. So that led me actually to my next question. So you've been watching me do this, but let's say that you haven't. And let's say this is your computer. And you pop into Explore and you're looking at your OneDrive and you're saying, okay, here's a folder and it's got a blue icon. The question is true or false, if a folder has the cloud icon or the blue icon, does that mean all files are in the cloud and not locally stored? The answer is no, you don't know. And this is the thing that drives people crazy. So I'm assuming I got a blue cloud, everything's in the cloud, but as you just saw, I open it up and no, I've got all three icons used. And again, I know I keep saying this, if just one file's got a blue icon, the folder's going to have a blue icon. So if you wanted all of these to be in the cloud, the easiest thing to do is not go to the files and put them all in the cloud. Go and right click the folder and just tell the folder to be free up space. It's going to be the same icon, but now watch. So here's a question. I'll go ahead and ask it. All three of those files should have now what icon? The cloud icon. And they do. If I was to download a folder, it would have the green check. If I want it to always be on my computer, that is always keep on this device. If I decide to run StorageSense, which you can or can't run, it's up to you. You don't have to run, it's my point. That is the program that Microsoft has. And if you work at a company, you may not be able to run it anyway, but personally you should be able to with Windows 10. That is the application that says, oh, okay, your hard drive's getting full. Do you want me to go and free up space? So it may delete stuff from your recycle bin, but for OneDrive, that's what we're worried about, you can tell it what to go and free up space for. If you recall, StorageSense will not free up space for a white check mark. That's the difference between the white check and the green check. Let me do another green check here. Let me double click and open this up. So StorageSense could get that first file, but it could not get the second file. And there's no reason to get the cloud-only file because that's not on your computer. So that would be the StorageSense question. The question was, If I turn on Storage Sense, what files will it affect? It'll affect the green checkmark only, called available on this device or locally available file. Those were the questions. I hope that helps. Those were great questions. Those came from my YouTube subscribers on my channel. I kept getting questions because that video was so popular, and I'm like, let me just do a Q&A about files and folders and these icons. So I hope that helps. Please take away this important note here. Just because a folder has the blue icon or the cloud icon does not mean everything inside that folder is cloud storage. You could have locally stored files. So what I would do, this is just me, act like there's a lot of folders. I could come in here, and I'm not going to do this. I'm holding down the control key. Let's say that in all those folders, I don't need the files locally. I would select the folders, right click, and here's where I'm going to stop. Free up space. That would take all the files from those selected folders and make them just available in OneDrive. So therefore, I would need an internet connection to get to them. Feel free to subscribe if you have any questions about the Q&A video I just made. Put them in the comments below. Have a great day off. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, and I appreciate your time. Thank you.